I had a simple plan for this video. Run benchmarks on a PC, then plug the same graphics card to the eGPU dock, repeat the same benchmarks, and end of story. But I had no idea how chaotic it would be at the end. And the question was quite simple: how much performance do we lose by using an eGPU compared to a direct connection? To find out, I have two graphics cards from different categories, an eGPU dock and a PC with Thunderbolt 4 port. Yes, I took it seriously, because this is the only way to test performance difference. Unlike the other test I found, I will have same CPU, RAM and so on. And I will test not just in games, but also in some applications. During the benchmarks, I didn't expect to see such results and decided to make a poll on my channel to get your opinion. And those who chose the option that we lose 30% of performance when we use an eGPU, congratulations, you were right. You chose 10%? Absolutely. Two times the performance loss? Sure. Three times? Five times? In fact, whichever option you choose, you would be right and wrong at the same time. But before we go any further, I suggest you to take a look at the benchmarks yourself. All tests are performed on an ultrawide monitor with a screen resolution of 3440 by 1440. Settings are maximum, DLSS quality if it's supported. And we'll start from RTX 4090. I should mention here that I tried to test without DLSS, and FPS stayed the same. And also I tried with ultra performance, and again, result was nearly the same. But I understand that for many of you it'll be more representative to test on a budget-friendly graphics card. So it's time to switch to the RTX 2060, and the list of games will be a bit different. But these few games in particular stand out from the rest. In Cyberpunk, the average FPS on RTX 4090 was 4 times lower, and in Red Dead Redemption 2, difference was up to 6 times. I've done the benchmarks for a few times, disabled integrated graphics, but the results remained the same. Just a reminder, in the results with RTX 2060, there was no such difference in performance. It seems strange to me, and I connected my handheld to the eGPU. It's Lenovo Legion Go with Ryzen Z1 Extreme CPU from AMD, and the result was much better and more stable. At this point, some of you will probably say that the problem is in my i5-13500. Alright, I'll get you i9-14900K. And guess what? Looks the same. This game has random FPS but still the same. And here nothing changed. But if you look at Red Dead Redemption 2, nothing has changed either. On the other hand, my little handheld shows the best result. So does it mean that AMD has a better compatibility with eGPU? Now it gets interesting. So I also made some benchmarks with my handheld. And I can say that some miracle happened. In best case the performance was similar, but mostly it was worse. And I would be surprised even more if it was otherwise. Apparently it's all about game optimization or some driver issue. In case it's fixable and you know some workarounds, please let us know in the comments. Now it's time to compare performance in some work applications. Let's start with Adobe Premiere Pro, rendering a 6-minute 4K video with 14900K and RTX 4090. My PC completed render in about 4 minutes, while the eGPU will do it in about 7 minutes. If you look at the power consumption of the GPU and its utilization, you can see why it was so much behind. Also, as requested from the comments, I checked image generation in Stable Diffusion. If we compare GPU to eGPU, they both utilize it in the same way. We can see a power consumption of 400 watts in both cases, which proves my point from other video that if tasks are not CPU intensive, eGPU works just fine. And the last one is Twin Motion. I loaded a demo scene and in parallel changed the weather, which has a good effect on the GPU load. Compared to previous tests, you can clearly see a difference here. Okay, we're done with the benchmarks. And what do we have in the end? A pretty simple idea for a video led me to a mess on my desk with several different CPUs, graphics cards, weeks of testing, analyzing and collecting results. All just to answer a simple question: how much performance are we losing by using eGPU? And as you can see, there is no concrete answer. But now we will realize that the result can be unpredictable. Sometimes it can be great, and sometimes it can be horrible. But I've tested only on a few games, and there are thousands, tens of thousands of games where eGPU could behave differently. And I haven't checked AMD GPUs yet. Sometimes the result depended on the CPU, and sometimes on the GPU, in the same game. But the main reason of that is the bandwidth limitation of the Thunderbolt connection. If you want to know what is the real Thunderbolt bandwidth speed when we use eGPU, how it works, how frames are generated for games, and how all these questions are connected between each other, feel free to check my other video.